So, man, it's like, I'm not surprised that there's going to be there is going to be interest in Joe Aribo simply because he's been Rangers' best player this year, and he's added the hardest thing to his game, and that's scoring goals. So he's going to attract interest. I'm sure if you ask any Rangers fan or every Rangers fan, they would love to see him get tied down in a new deal. I know he's got a couple of seasons left, but look, there's going to be interest because he's a very, very good player.
Joe Aribo, you'd pay money to go and see him, wouldn't you?
Yeah, outstanding. You know, I think Ryan Kent's form obviously has improved recently, but you know, over the last, what, 6 months or so, Aribo's been the top performer. You know, Morelos and Kent are the two headline acts, if you like, in terms of Rangers getting really good money for selling players. But Aribo, for me, has been outstanding.
He's come up fast in the rails, isn't he? Terrific player.
Yeah, he's improving all the time. Mm-hmm. I mean, he's got all the attributes a midfielder needs. He's strong, powerful, can get about the pitch, can handle the ball, can dribble. And as I said, he's scoring goals. And that was a brilliant bit of business. I think they paid £300,000. That was the fee that they had to give Charlton. And the way he's performing, you're talking over £10 million now.
Who found him? Do we know who it was?
Steven Gerrard signed him.
Steven Gerrard, yeah. I just wonder in the, you know, in the recruitment
department. It's a good story. I'm not too sure, Davey, but he came from non-league. Yep. I think it was tier 7, I think he was playing in.
Wow. Maybe it was Russell.
Charlton took a chance on him. Had a season or two down there under my ex-teammate Lee Bowyer. Mm-hmm. He was devastated to lose him. And he's come up here and he's just improved every single season. And for me, he's Rangers' main player.
He sure is. Ryan, it reminds you a bit, a different player I know, but Tom Rogic, when you talked about a tall midfielder who's getting some goals and playing well, can dance through the defences. Rogic having his best season ever at Celtic.
Yeah, you can put that down to the manager, can't you? There's obviously a relationship there from the Australian national team. Under Neil Lennon, Tom Rogic was a bit part player. Mm. And now he's one of the mainstays.
How does that happen, Davey?
I really don't know. I thought Tom Rogic would have left Celtic. You know, the lack of action he got under Neil Lennon, I thought he'd have said, I'm out of here. I want to play every week. And I think he had a good offer from the Middle East, if I'm right.
Qatar,
yeah. Yeah, and the money would have been phenomenal. So I was surprised he stayed, but certainly Ange Postecoglou will be delighted he stayed because he's getting the best out of him.
Big dough, wasn't it? Sorry, guys. Doha.
We go all right.
I thought Davey was just, he was wincing at that time.
He's a player, Tom Rogic.
Sure is, isn't he?
He is a player. No, just ability wise, he's strong. Mm-hmm. Watching the game on Sunday, I think it was Newell a couple of times trying to get in about him and he bounced off him.
Yeah.
So again, you wonder why he didn't play for many more than 40, 50 minutes up until this season.
Yeah, I spoke to Craig Moore about that. Because there was a lot made, is it his fitness? Yeah. He's like, no, there's no issue with his fitness. Trains every day, does the full pre-seasons. Just strange that he never lasted 90 minutes.
Tell Alexa to launch Go Radio or listen on the Go Radio app.